ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवी सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयामुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति निष्ठिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः।
हरे कृष्णा देवी आर रिसाइटिंग रीडिंग श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 6 द प्रिस्क्राइब ड्यूटीज फॉर द मैनकाइंड चैप्टर 15 एंटाइटल्ड नारद एंड अंगिरा इंस्ट्रक्ट किंग चित्रकेतु टेक्स्ट नंबर 7 प्लीज रिसाइट।
देहे ना देहि नो राजन देहा देहो अभिजायते बीजा देव यथा बीजा देहार्थ एव शाश्वतः। देहिना देहिनो राजन् देहादेहो अभिजायते बीजा देव यथा बीजम् देहार्थेव शाश्वता। देहिना देहिनो राजन् देहा देहो अभिजायते बीजा देव यथा बीजम् देहार्थ एव शाश्वतः।
Word to word meaning translation purport by His Divine Grace Abhay Charanarvind Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki
Dehina by the body, Dehina of the father possessing a material body, Rajan O king, Dehat from the body of the mother, Deha, another body, Abhijayate, takes birth, Bijat, from one seed, Eva,
indeed, yatha, just as, bijam, another seed, dehi, a person who has accepted a material body, arathaha, the material elements, eva, like, shashwataha, eternal. Translation. As from one seed, another seed is generated, O King. So from one body, the body of the father, through another body, the body of the mother, a third body is generated, the body of son, of a son. As the elements of the material body are eternal, the living entity who appeared through these material elements is also eternal. Kindly repeat after me. As from one seed, another seed is generated, O King. So from one body, the body of the father, through another body, the body of the mother, a third body is generated, the body of a son. As the elements of material body are eternal, the living entity who appeared through these material elements is also eternal. Purport. From Bhagavad Gita, we understand that there are two energies, namely superior energy and inferior energy. Inferior energy consists of five gross and three subtle material elements. Bhumi Rapi Anadavayu Khammano Buddhi Revacha Ahankaram Temi Bhinna Prakriti Ashtada. The living entity who represents the superior energy appears in different type of bodies through these elements by the manipulation or supervision of material nature. Actually, both the material and spiritual energies, matter and spirit, exist eternally as potencies of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The potent entity of the Supreme Person, the potent entity of the Supreme Person, the potent entity is the Supreme Person. Since the spiritual energy, the living being, who is a part and partial of the Supreme Lord, desire to enjoy this material world, the Lord gives him the chance to accept different types of material bodies or enjoy or suffer in different material conditions. Factually, the spiritual energy, the living entity who desire to enjoy material things, is manipulated by the Supreme Lord. The so-called father and mother have nothing to do with the living entities. As a result of his own choice and karma, the living entity takes different bodies through the agency of so-called father and mother. Omagyanatimirandhasya jnananjana salakaya chakshurunmilitam mena tasmai shri gurave namaha श्री चैतन्य मनोहविष्टं स्थापितं मेन भूतले स्वयं रूपाकरमहं ददाति स्वापदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरोन् वैष्णवांश श्रीरूपां साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश नमो विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणी हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेशा गोपिका कांत
राधाकांत नमोस्तुते।
तप्त कांचन गौरांगी श्री राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरत्यसे नमः। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हुकम करो दिवाचाल पंगुलंगातिमंदे श्रीगुरुण श्रीचैतन्यश्वर परमानंद।
हरे कृष्ण। So before speaking on this transcendental subject matter, I seek the blessings of all Ashambal Vaishnavas so I can speak something for glorification of the Lord and my own purification, and we can do little some justice with this verse. So very important section is going on. The canto itself indicates that prescribed duties of mankind, you know, manav samaj ke kartavyon ka varnan. So pura skand, the full canto is describe the duties of the mankind especially, and this chapter also very instructive section. Narad and Angira instruct the king Chitraketu, king Chitraketu, who was the king of the whole world. So as we all knows many times this repeated this story, the past time, that how the situation comes, because like that king Chitraketu have 1 crore wives, still not having any offspring, son. So especially being the king of the whole world, he was thinking it's my responsibility also, someone should be there to take care. That is there, but some in back of mind there's some kind of attachment was there. But it is said also, na, Chanakya said that putra heenam griha sunyam. If like son is not there, children are not there, then this is a, like home is vacant. No, if children are not there, no prosperity, no happiness. So now after this all incidents, by the grace of Angira Muni, he got a son, and because of that he got little partial or become little is irresponsible towards his wives, other wives, co-wives of Kriti Duti. Because of that the son got poisoned and all things happen. So now we can see now in the picture again Angira Rishi came with the Narada. So the question may come like even one is sufficient to deliver the thousand of the living entity. So why, what is the need of come both of them to come together? So it is said like especially in the critical situation, they might have thought like this is like little critical case, so both need to go together. Sometimes in our preaching also, na, one senior and one junior need to go. Jai Jai Shishi Radha Madan Mohan Ji Ki, Shishi Krishna Balaram Ji Ki, Jagannath Valdeshwadra Maya Ki, Prahladesh Narsingh Dev Bhagwan Ki, Patit Pavan Shri Gaurnatai Ki. So, as in the preaching, we used to go also, like generally said, preacher should not go alone. Try to avoid. And especially in such type of situation, when there is a too much joy, celebration, and too much sorrow, lamentation. And this teaching, this example is shown by Lord Krishna himself, after the battlefield of the Mahabharata, to give the solace to the all the Pandavas, Lord went along with the many great sages, not alone. Because when one is in like distress situation, someone should be there along with us, so we can properly give the solace to that person, advice. So here Angira was the senior, he was the third son of the Brahma, and then Narad is the junior. Sometimes Narad, and this parampara is continue. So now we are also taking The preachers are also taking, senior devotees taking junior with them. Like sometimes Narad used to take some Parvat Muni, some other pastime. So like generally. So another thing, like the first time when Angara came, he not directly instructed to Chitraketu. Because that time he was not in the condition of to listen the transgender subject matter. Because he was too much attached. And the same thing is told by the Lord in the Bhagavad Gita, like one should not instruct the person who is too much attached, especially householder who is too much attached, one should not instruct. But Prabhupada mentioned like devotees are more compassionate than the Lord. So sometimes still somehow directly, indirectly, they want to give some dose at least. Okay, now you have to come out in different way. They try to give the instruction to the householders. So here we can see in this pastime, like it seems like Chitraketu Maharaj is doing over endeavor, and because of passion, he might have thought, okay, one wife, two wives, 300, 1000, 1000, 1 lakh, okay, that's enough. But it's like hum honge kamyab ek din. So like this is out of passion. When person is having too much passion, then he doesn't want to stop. He doesn't want to take the advice also from the seniors and the instruction of the scriptures. So as Lord himself mentioned that what is the in Bhagavad Gita 14.16, Lord is mentioning that karmana hi sukratasya satvikam nirmalam phalam rajasah tu phalam dukham ajnanam tamasah phalam. The result of pious actions is pure and said to be in the mode of goodness, and that brings the happiness. But the action done in the mode of passion results in misery. Mentioned like initially it may look like nectar, but at the end it becomes poison. And the action performed in the mode of ignorance is results of foolishness, delusion. It's from the beginning also like poison, at the end also like poison. So everything that is because the influence of the modes of material nature. Prakriti kriya manahani gunha karmani sarvasha ahankara mudatma karataham iti mani. Due to influence by the modes of material nature. But if one is intelligent enough and following the instruction, especially in this case, one can understand, like Bhagavata mentioned another place also, like this verse comes, karmana devanitrena yantra dehru paddhate striya pravashya udro punsa reta kanashraya. Because of this, everything is happening under the supervision of superior energy of the Lord or material nature. So before going to this verse, we'll take a quick recap. Otherwise, sometimes we tend to forget piche kya chala gaya thoda sa usko. I'll go. So in second verse we discussed the theme was like the relationship in this world is not factual. It is temporary, not permanent. And third verse discussed that union and separation of the jiva is due to the force of time. Every one of us under the influence of the time. And other modes also. As mentioned by the Narad Muni to Yudhishthira Maharaj, Kala Karma Gunodhina Dehoyam Pancha Bhautikam Katham Manyastu Gopaya Sarpagraste Mukhi Grasa. Something like this. I'm missing fourth line. So, and next, in the fourth verse, mentioned the potency of the Lord's energy, Maya. It's mentioned that by Lord's Maya and potency, ordinance, fertility, by mercy, like Lord's grace only, people having that potency to develop the child. Otherwise, because of that only, they get parenthood. If Lord is not merciful, no matter, as mentioned Prabhupada last time, purport, like why it is happening, despite of so much endeavor, people not getting children. And sometimes they doesn't want also, still children are coming. So why? Because controlled by the superior energy of the Lord. And fifth verse mentioned that material relationship do not exist in all three phases of time. So that is like, example is given of dream. Bhakti Prem Swami Maharaj was describing that time, like dream that is like not exist. So like our this life is also like a dream only. Before dream, we don't remember, and after dream also, only in between. And verse number 6 mentioned, like previous verse, as Vibhu Chetan Prabhu covered yesterday, Lord, though unattached, create, maintain, and destroy like a child playing, like play of the child. Create, maintain, and destroy. Here example is given the child at some extent, but it is not proper 100%. Because when child creates something, he got attached. Whether he is making the casual and the shisho or somewhere. But Lord, not at having a single aura of attachment. Aura of attachment. Just see, think, like how many of us are ready to start such a project that we have to going to bind up? After few years, few months. Or even maybe authority may desire, then we start also. But we may not able to put our full endeavor, because we know anyway we have to close down after 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, close it down. But just see, what about Lord? He's creating this whole universe, whole creation, creating all the things, and he's knowing that after some time he has to bind up, but still he's maintaining, like it is eternal, never going to destroy, in that mood. So neither he is attached during creation. Maintenance also, he is maintaining but not attached. Mentioned that the Lord in the Bhagavad Gita. And the same time during inhalation also, when he destroys, not attached. So just see, like how like inconceivable the detachment of the Lord. You can see it is inconceivable. Lord is, though he knows that one time after it, like another second breathe in his breathing, again whole creation is going to destroy. But still he is maintaining, or he's sending his part and partial to maintain this creation. And then now in seventh verse, today's verse, the theme is like parents create the body but not the soul. Means the soul is not of parents. Like suppose a person is getting a car, a Ford is giving a car for someone. So the car may belong to the Ford, but that person is not belong to the Ford. Similarly, this body is given by the parents, so maybe this body belongs. But the person inside the body, that is not belongs to the parents. That is there. So here, in the beginning, Prabhupada gave the reference of the Bhagavad Gita. To understand that these are two energies, superior and inferior energy, and because an inferior energy consists of the five gross and subtle elements that we already discussed, and after a certain period of the time, Lord inhalates also. So everything is happening under the sweet will of the Lord. In Bhagavad Gita 9.4, Lord mentioned, Prakritim Swam Avas Sabhyas Vishyajami punaha punaha bhutagramam imam krishtam avashtvam prakritir vashat. The whole cosmic order is under me. Under my will, it is automatically manifested again and again. And under my will, it is annihilated at the end. So, as per the desire of the Lord, here, desire of living entity is not working, whether living entity want or not want. So, like, Suryanash Bhakti Saraswami Maharaj was mentioning, like, Vibhu Chetan Prabhu was sharing with me, like, Maharaj mentioned in one of the lecture, that during the inhalation, all the creation is like, again enter in the body of Mahavishnu, unbind. Rebinding all things, and all living entity enter in the body of the Lord. So means all of us enter in the body of the Lord, means spiritual world, but we are in so much ignorance and deep sleep that we are unable to understand that we are in an spiritual world. And again, because of this, the living entity, those are having a desires, because of that desire, we have to come back again when creation takes place again. So, we see in this, whatever the incidents happen, this like the Krutiditi, co-wife say, given the poison to the son, that was out of envy. So it is like, and many incidents in the history, in the scriptures we see envy, like you can see the incidents of the Gandhari, when she got to know that Kunti gave the birth before her, so that she beaten her womb and the flesh come out. But as Vyasadev given the wound, you will get 100 sons. Then he did all the technology and 100 sons developed. Like this all. So this one example, another this example Krutiditi is there. Duryodhan, he was like also because of envy only. Just see, once he got a chance to get a great boon from the Durvasa Muni, he could get some great boon, some big thing. But what he asked from Durvasa Muni? Just go and meet with the Pandavas and take prasad at their home, because he was aware that they may not able to do. But as Lord was there, Yatra Yageshwaro Krishna, there Vijay, victory is sure. And the whole incident is their pastime, so wonderful pastime. So, in one lecture, Bhakti Saraswami Maharaj was mentioning, like, envy is like an aerial antenna. You know, antenna, seen this? Radio antenna. One. So Maharaj was telling, like, in this envy, all anarthas are there inside. You know, ek ke baad ek karke unfold hote hain. This antenna, as you open this antenna, one. So like, anger, greed, lust, and other things manifest. So if we said that, giving out all anarthas, like, if we can give up the envy, it is a one stroke method. If we are able to give up the envy, then all anarthas will go. But it is not easy, because of that only we came over here, na? So the biggest task. But it's said, like, by glorifying the devotees, and following the prescribed principle of devotional service, eventually this envy will go. So, because it's said in spiritual world, NV means no vacancy. N matlab no, V vacancy, no vacancy. If one having NV, then no vacancy in the spiritual world. No, allowed, not allowed. Board laga hai. Envious people are not allowed. So, you cannot enter in the spiritual world. Here, in the this pastime, like, we can see there are some special characteristics of the Chitraketu we'll go through. Like, what are the different qualities? So here Prabhupada mentioned the so-called father and mother had nothing to do with the living entity. So-called. Many times Prabhupada used to this famous word, so-called. This naam ke liye, name, so-called guru or so-called scientist, whatever. So here also mentioned so-called father and mother, just for the sake of name only. Otherwise everything is under the supervision of the Lord's energy is going on. Just these are the instruments. Lord is making the instruments. It's mentioned in Prema Bhakti Chandrika, Prati Janme Janme, Pita Mata Pai, Guru Krishna Nahi Mile, Bhajo Hari Bhai. Something like this. So, like mentioned, so every birth after birth, either we are in the body of cat, dog, or human beings, we are getting a father and mother. But only in the human form of the life, by the mercy of the Lord, we are getting a chance to meet with the spiritual master. And by the mercy of the spiritual master, we are getting a chance to go back to Godhead, to meet with the Lord. So now we'll discuss some of the characteristics of the Chitraketu Maharaj, different qualities. we have reading this section of the Chitraketu since long, so I have taken some points. Like Chitraketu was such a great king that he's even glorified by the great Mahajan, Lord Shiva. Shiva is the greatest Mahajan. Vaishnavanam yatha sambhu. Even Lord Shiva was glorifying when this upcoming incidents, when Parvati crushed the Chitraketu, and Chitraketu not retaliated, he accepted the curse. So that time Lord Shiva is glorifying Chitraketu. And in the previous chapters we can see the grateful attitude of the Chitraketu. Gratitude, one quality of the Chitraketu was gratitude. He was grateful towards his forefathers, not only towards forefather as well as the saintly person, those are giving the enlightenment for him. That's why he was asking for the sun. He was grateful to his forefathers. So he doesn't want like if the sun was not there, then who will perform other ritualistic obligations and all? Otherwise they will fall down from their pitarlok and all. So because of that only he was asking, or he was desiring, intensely desiring to have a sun, because he was having a gratitude towards his forefather. And obviously he was having gratitude towards all saintly people who used to visit his assembly time to time. Another quality was, he was having great quality of hospitality. Just see, when Angra Rishi arrived, then how he received him. So that is mentioned there. He was very respectful for all saintly person, and he was very exemplary, being the king of the whole world. Yadiyadi Asharati Shrishta. And that is mentioned, like the same thing is exemplary behavior is shown by the Lord himself, either when he came in the form of Lord Ramachandra, Lord Krishnachandra, or Lord Gaurachandra. And every time Lord is shown his, by his example, how to respect the saintly people, how to respect the elderly people. And even respecting the elders, like what to speak out, getting the like spiritual benefit that obviously we are getting, there are the many material benefits also. When we respect our elder people, then one verse is mentioned like this. I think Kalidas mentioned that when one respect the elderly people, then yash, fame, name, beauty, strength increase. Avivadana shilashya nityam vradhyopasevina chatvaretasya vardhantu ayur vidya yasho balam. Four things. So even if one is not aware the spiritual benefit of respecting elders, okay, but at least for the sake of material benefits also, we should respect. The next quality of Chitraketu was, he was having a proper spirit of mood. He presented himself when Narada Muni arrived, or before that Angra Muni arrived, he presented himself like a fool number one. He was so humble. He's telling like, no, I am not knowing, I am not aware of the spiritual principles, just let me know. So how I can overcome from the situation of lamentation. But the another drawback, you can say drawback or some fault in his like character, was he was partially dutiful. Partially. Why partially? Because in one hand, to getting the son, he was performing his all prescribed duties. He's respecting the elderly people, respecting the saintly people. So that time he is showing his responsibility, being a king. But on another hand, he was partial or neglectful towards his duty. What kind of duty? Can anyone say? What kind of duty Chitraketu was neglectful? Jai Jai Shri Radha Madan Mohan Ji Ki Jai, Shri Krishna Balaram Ji Ki Jai, Jagannath Baladev Yashodhara Maiya Ki, Prahladesh Narasimha Dev Bhagwan Ki, Patit Pavan Shri Gaur Nitai Ki. Yeah, very nice. Abhay Charan Prabhu said like he was partial or he's not able to give the sufficient time to other wives. He's neglecting. So that was he was partial because of his attachment. So attachment leads to the partial, like partiality. You can see in our life also, and practical examples. Like when it's partial, when it's attached to someone, then automatically this partiality comes. Dealings and everything. About giving the resources, giving the facilities, everything. So if one is not attached, then this problem can be overcome. Another quality of Chitraketu was he was very submissive also. He was submissive toward the Narad Muni. And after this incident, when Narad Muni gave him the instruction, he followed wholeheartedly. And he attains the Lord. He was a devotee of the Lord Shankarshan. So he attains the Lord. But then Lord sent him to other planetary systems because for him give them more chance to enjoy this world and all. But another thing, he was very much sense controlled also. In one sense, like because he was like in next chapter, their pastimes comes like when he was flying in his airplane along with the woman. But what he was doing? He was glorifying the Lord, glorifying the devotees. So that only Chitraketu can do because he was in that level. So he was uncompromising in that, like he was fully absorbed in the glorification of the Lord. Another quality is mentioned that like he was having a prayerful mood, prayerful attitude. Like throughout his journey he was praying to the Lord, he was glorifying the Lord, he was glorifying the Bhagavad Dharma. And after cursing by Parvati, he was accepted. He is not retaliating, not counter cursing. Even Prabhupada mentioned and like further that purport that he was capable, that much potency he is having because he is seen Lord Shankarshan face to face. He was the friend of the Lord Shiva. So he was having that potency that he could curse, counter curse, but still he's tolerated. So this means despite of having the ability, despite of having a potency, despite of having a power, he's able to tolerate. But what happened in our case sometimes, like if we are not able to, someone is like chastising us or something, then what have we thought, like okay, अभी नहीं है मौका आएगा का हमारे पास भी जब आएगा शक्ति आए देख सबका दिन आता है हमारा भी दिन आएगा प्रभु तो बट दो द पर्सन इज नॉट हैविंग बट द वी आर नॉट हैविंग द पोटेंशी एंड पावर स्टिल वी थॉट कभी ना कभी तो अपना भी दिन आएगा भाई एंड वी आर हैविंग दैट रिवेंज कीप दैट रिवेंज इन द माइंड बट हियर चित्रकेतु डिस्पाइट हैविंग अ पोटेंशी एंड पावर इज नॉट रिटेलिएटिंग इज एक्सेप्टेड the curse of the Parvati. And he was detached already, I told, because in assembly of the women, he is glorifying the Lord. He is not attached. So in conclusion, we can see, and another thing, like in upcoming sections, we'll read that he was quite concerned also. Like sometimes there are the two things are there, na? Circle of concern, in circle of influence. And when we are in at any field, either in the spiritual organization or an outside material organization, anywhere, and even at home, two things are there. There's a two circle. One is circle of concern, that is a big circle, and inside that there's a circle of influence, where a person having influence. So it is advised by the authority, like one should mostly focus on a circle of influence rather to circle of concern. But at least circle of concern should also be shown. It's required. Someone should be there, na? Like and other day, 3-4 days back, when Sixkashtam Prabhu was given the class, on Brahmachari class, he was mentioning, like, even when difficulties and problems come, even the part of the body is helping each other. Correct, na? Like when one get any injury, suddenly hand goes and rub, what happened? Eyes goes, what happened? Sometimes, suddenly, automatically. So much coordination in the bodily parts. Because their concern is there. Similarly, in the organization, especially when we are working together for the same mission, we should be concerned of each other, not to be over concerned. But if we find something is going here and there, something we find, then we can approach to the particular authority or particular person. You can say, Prabhuji, I'm observing like in disciple course also, I was hearing before giving the class, like if we are find something here and there in some devotee authority, then we should not directly blame that. We can go to the authority and say, Prabhuji, I'm observing this like this only, but I'm not able to understand. So what I should do? And this devotee is little maybe out of track or whatever. So please do the needful. That is concern. So we need to concern. It's not like that. We should not be like, always I want to be in goodwill only. Jo ho raha chalne do, apni gaadi chal rahi hai. Hai na? No. We are in the family, same family, na? So if someone is struggling, and Prabhuji was mentioning, like giving the inspiration to someone is the biggest thing. Because everyone of us has to go through the process up and down like this zigzag in spiritual life. Rupa Goswami mentioned that ahirer gati, correct na? Ahirer gati, saap ki tarah. Sometimes we will come like up and down in spiritual life. So maybe today that person is going through that process, tomorrow we have to go. So we have to help it out. That is already Prabhuji mentioned. I am just repeating to remind it for myself also. So he showed his concern, great concern. Why? To protect the living entity, normal jiva, to not to misunderstand seva. So he directly in joking way, he was correcting or showing the concern to the seva. Like, you are the great Mahajan, you are doing like this. But he was not like blaming some kind of thing, but he was showing his concern. Like what other may think, because normal living entity may misunderstood. Another thing, like then after upcoming incidents, like he was very wise also, intelligent. Because when Parvati cursed, even before that also, Lord giving the boon. So he was aware of the futility of this material world. He was aware of the futility of this heaven or hell, curse or benediction. So he was not much afflicted. The material world that is for a short period of time only. So that's why he not asked some material benefits also. So in conclusion, we can see this, like the relationship of this material worlds are temporary. As previously verses mentioned that like rivers, in the river different leaves are coming together and they're separated also. This example is given somewhere else also in the Bhagavatam. When all living entities through the current of the river, they are coming and eventually they are separating also by the influence of the time. So similarly, we all come together because of the influence of the time in the family, and when Lord desires according to his will, we get separated also. So this relationship is temporary, but it's not like that. We should be practical also. Like everything is, like we can see in the life of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, though they are purely situated in the spiritual platform, but they have taken their material responsibilities also. When Nawab Hussain Shah used to come, they used to give the proper respect. It's not like that it's temporary, it's like for the time being only, just so called king only, and like Malik Shah and all. No, he is giving the proper respect to Nawab Hussain Shah. Similarly, for all of us also, being the spiritualist or trying to be the spiritualist, we should be practical. You should try to come on the spiritual platform, but not to neglect the material duties also. You cannot say, if you go to the home, generally, kabhi kabhi jab jaate hain, to maa bolti, beta dubla ho gaya hai. Main shareer nahi hoon, main atma hoon. Kya bol raha hai beta? But saying, I am your mother, main maa hoon. Maa nahi, maya ho, maya. Then difficult, it's problem. So we should be practical. Not like we should not deal fanatically. As you can see in the life of our acharyas, they were very like Raghunath Das Goswami and others, Raghunath Bhatt Goswami, even Prabhupada. His spiritual master gave him the instruction, but he did his responsibility. Then only even he was desiring, he accepted the spiritual master, but did his responsibility. So simultaneously we should come out to the spiritual platform, but whimsically we should not neglect our material duties. So there are many lessons we already derived from this section of the Chitraketu, like how should be dutiful, how should be respectful, you know, how should be detached, and all. So these are all the pastimes. Chitraketu was undoubtedly pure devotee of the Lord and Lord Shiva and all. But this is for the teachings. Like as another day, like Sixkast Kumaru was mentioning, this all the pastimes we can take in two point of view. One is spiritual and material. Spiritual point of view, like we can see, like these all are the great souls, pure devotee of the Lord. Why? Because of that we will not commit the mistake, offense towards them. But materially or humanly we will see these pastimes, so we should not commit the mistake. We can take the lesson. Like Bharat Maharaj, we cannot say, okay Bharat Maharaj, if he get fall down, then main to kya hu Prabhu, chalta hai. Or Brahma, another pastime. So like this only. So there are many other important lessons about to come, especially this next section, Parvati cursing the Chitraketu and all incidents. So now I'll stop here. Thank you very much. Please forgive me, like if I was some out of track or something like this. Thank you very much. Shri Prabhupada ki, Granthana Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Samvet Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki. Once I close the paths in the way which are